I got acquainted with these seeds when I started eating Falooda. Initially, I didn't like its taste. Rather, I found it highly tasteless. Until I learned its health benefits while studying nutrition. Certainly, it didn't change its taste for me, but my point of view towards these seeds. They are nothing but basil seeds or sabja seeds. Hello my foodie buddies, I am nutritionist Prachi and I welcome you all to my another episode of Unsung Heroes of Kitchen, and today we would be discussing about basil seeds or sabja seeds. Anyhow, the summer is approaching, so I thought why not to take the coolest seeds of the season, right? You know, these are those tiny unique seeds which when gets mixed with water gets swollen up so beautifully, and the process is so wonderful to watch. I at times just look at that process and it's really wonderful. You know guys, whenever we are eating a particular food with particular intention or particular reason, apart from that particular reason, that food gives us much more than what we would ask for. Like if you're not aware about any other health benefits of curry leaves apart from its flavoring agent, but still after consumption is going to give you plenty of other health benefits. Same applies to sabja seeds as well. Probably you might be eating as them as they are just the cooling seeds in the summers, but apart from the cooling property, it has much more to give us. So let us learn these sabja seeds from nutrition point of view. Now these tiny seeds are very low in calories but high in fiber, proteins, omega-3 fatty acids, vitamin K, minerals like calcium, magnesium and iron, plant compounds like flavonoids and polyphenols. Of course, as I said, there are plenty of health benefits, but three takeaway points as we have kept on discussing in my earlier episodes as well. Sabja seeds, first takeaway point is it's rich in fiber, particularly soluble fiber and pectin. So what all it does? It gives a satiety, that is a feeling of fullness, helps in digestion, in turn helps in weight loss as well, prevents constipation, lowers or controls the cholesterol levels. Do not let your blood sugar levels spike up, especially after meals. So it's good for type 1 and type 2 diabetes people and also helps in preventing the metabolic disorders. Second, these sabja seeds are a rich source of omega-3 fatty acids. See, particularly vegetarian sources are not much rich source of omega-3 fatty acids comparing to fish. But yes, there are certain foods which definitely provides you good amount of omega-3 fatty acids, and sabja seed is one of them. And particularly it contains alpha-linolenic acid. Now what all benefits does it provide to our body? First of all, it helps in fighting against anxiety, depression. It helps in fetal development, helps in controlling ADHD, that is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, boosts metabolism and burns extra fat. And the third point is, as we all know, that they have this cooling property, that they helps in beating the scorching heat, also lowers the body heat and helps in soothing the stomach. So how much these sabja seeds must be consumed? 1 to 2 teaspoons per day is enough. And how are you supposed to consume it? The ideal consumption of sabja seeds is add them in water in bottle filled with water for 15 to 20 minutes, and then as they get swollen up, then after that you can drink that bottled water throughout the day, particularly before your meals, so that will also reduce your food intake. In turn, it can help you in maintaining and losing the weight as well. But apart from that, you can add them in smoothies, yogurts or oatmeals, or you can add them in certain milkshakes, okay, like the way we add in falooda, or salad dressings or smoothies, etc. The over-consumption of sabja seeds does provide an adverse effect, okay, particularly for three sort of people. First of all, people who are on blood thinning drug treatments are supposed to avoid, because it is rich in vitamin K, which has a particular role in blood clotting. Second is, it's not good for hypoglycemic patients or people who have a tendency of low blood sugar levels, because it drops glucose levels instantly. Okay, and third, not for pregnant women. Always remember guys, when we discuss about any particular food, you have to make a combination of that food with other foods as well. So incorporating all of the necessary foods and your lifestyle definitely can give you the results that you expect from food. So soul food doesn't help in giving you the result, but yes, incorporating it into your lifestyle definitely helps you in giving you the results. So it's always holistic approach that works. So stay extra cool this summer with our darling Sabja seeds. Till then, bye bye. Stay healthy inside out. Bye.